To be inspired is great, but to be an inspiration is a honor. Good afternoon to one and all. Now we will start the session 4. It's my privilege to welcome our session chair for presentation, Dr. P.K. Muhammad Imran, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Islamia College, Vaniyambadi. I welcome you, sir. Next, I would like to welcome all the department heads, faculty members, research scholars, and students from various institutions. Let's start with the participants' presentation. I request all the participants to give their presentation 5 to 7 minutes. Kindly follow the time limit. Thank you.
Hello, I'm not hearing the sound very soft. Sound, please.
Greetings to everyone. Myself, I am pursuing my master in chemistry, second year. So my topic today is about nanotechnology in nature. I have observed five topics in it. Before going to the concept, let me introduce what is nanotechnology here. So nanotechnology is nothing but it's a nanoparticles or microparticles. Nature is nothing but already a nature process. So how it is going to how nanotechnology involves in nature, we are going to see it. So first we'll be talking about shark skin, lotus effect, butterfly colors, Kago, and talk and bee. So first is natural nanomaterials. Natural nanomaterial here is it is mean a material belongs to the natural world, animals or minerals without human modifications or processing, and that has been remarkable properties because they are inherent in nanostructures. So first is nanotechnology involves in how it is involved in shark skin. So we all know that the shark skin has been swimming in the oceans for millions of years without problematic accumulations of algae and bacteria on the surface of their skin. For this, it is because due to the nano scale pattern, so on the skin, on the sharp skin defects, and it is without the effect of algae and bacteria. It is called as anti-foils and algal of bacteria. It tends to settle in the surface, and it is established in the colonies called bioclimbs. It is early in the colonies of smooth surface, whereas it is established in bioclimbs over a rough surface, required too much energy to colonizations, and makes signals between in it. So shark skin, mainly we know what is shark skin. So how nanotechnology involved here is, you can see the screen here. I have displayed the shark skin here. So the interior between it is shark skin, and the surface, they are essential in the form of ships, submarines, etc. So this is how nanotechnology involves in the shark skin. Next is a lotus effect. So normally we know what is lotus and it leaves. Normally when we took a leaf,
it's not moving now.
So how it absorbs? In the sense, water, it gets repels each other, and the leaf of the surface get clean, and it functions very magnifiedly. So here is a picture of how it repels. So this concept has been extra plotted and applied in the waterproof of mobiles and protecting fabrics, woods, and other surface of dirt and dust. So next is butterfly colors. So normally we know what is the colors of butterfly. They are different in color. Butterfly wings are the layers of nanoparticles, and it is separated by the layer of airs. And the thickness of the layer changes by the color, as we see in the screen. And the nanostructures are coated with the hydrophobic wax, which is in crystals, and it is approximately 1 nanometer in a diameter. And it makes the surface in a nano scale. It is quite rough in the structures. So how butterfly is used in the nanotechnology, in the sense by a barcode, or we can say it as a, we can have it scan. You can note it in a CAM scan, you can see it in a barcode. So it depends upon what we need, and then that nanoparticles, it may be inferences in the proteins and DNA of virus and diseases. So normally I have said in the end, it is used in the barcodes. So Kego is nothing but it's a reptile which belongs to the family of lizards. And it is a unique ability to scale the vertical surface of both strong attachments of their toes and to the surface of coupled, and it is easy to wrap it and in the removals. They are able to do this due to the attractive force and millions of nano scales are in the hair of Kegos. You can see in the next picture, that is, it is the toe of Kego reptiles, and it is weakly attached to the force and exists between the chemicals and the materials. It has approximately 500,000 hairs per toes and 100 nano project. It is a spatula per hairs. And next is Toucan beak. Toucan is nothing but it's a bird. It is also a toucan beak. We can note it is as a nano structures, and it inspires the automotive panels, and it could be protective for passengers. Whereas it inspires conceptions of ultra light aircraft compounds, and its extraordinary toucan beaks is made up of overlapping of nano size tiles and etc. So here we can notice our human skin of human nails. It is also a nano technology involved in our nails. And so this is a pictures of nano technology that which is absorbed in toucan beaks. It is an interior beaks in the regards of man networks and nano size bony fibers which is connected with membranes. This allows the beaks to absorb the light, energy and impact. So thank you.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. Myself. Good afternoon to Manindra present here. Myself T. Gajra Devi from second MSc Chemistry. My topic is about importance of chemistry in our daily life. First, in importance, we have a major importance is flame. We used to have a flame in everything, like in laboratories, industries, as well as in home for cooking, etc. Chemistry isn't just in factories or labs, but it is an omnipresent. Omnipresent means it will be present in everywhere, inside all the spheres, etc. Furthermore, taking chemistry as a subject enhances our ability to apply chemistry in our daily life. Without chemistry, we can't able to live in any way. For example, in the initial classes at lab, we used to have a color of flames. Tells us how much hand is present available to the burner. Sometimes we used to get a yellow color and sometimes we used to get a blue color. If the flame is yellow color, it shows there is a small amount of air. If we have a blue color, then it is a sufficient air is possible so that we can able to perform with more safetiness. Next, likewise, same principle can be applied while we are cooking. While we are going to cook, in LPG stove, we used to have a blue flame. But in the burners or etc. in big of cookings, we used to have a burners like in a mass quantity. So likewise, the same principles can be applied while we are in cooking in kitchen. If we notice a yellow flame in cooking range, we know it means that air valves is being blocked. So that the gas is being leaked, so that we have to remove that. So this signals needs and helps us to clean and it helps us to repair. This example highlights how chemistry helps us to identify and fix the simple issues too. Being a flame is a simple issue in our life, but in that also chemistry is playing a major role in that. And it also fixes simple issues in our daily lives on our own and helps us to independent and self-reliant. Next. Many of the changes and variants you observe in the world are caused by the chemical reactions. Knowing some chemistry can help you to make day-to-day life decisions that affect your life. Example, knowing what to mix, in which food we have what to mix in that, and what quantity has to be mixed. In that same quantity, they have many compounds like NaCls, etc. That also belongs to chemistry, which confirms that chemistry is presenting even in a small items too. Next. Chemistry made us to real things have an expiry date. Before expiry date, we don't know that we used to eat in all the time. But after, while the chemistry is being introduced and they have painted the expiry date, that expiry date have been helped. That is important to watch out for eating. That also helps us to the health issues too. In medicines, there are abolitions of the diseases and major contribution to improving the human health have been made by the modern chemical discoveries. Chemical discoveries helps to major issues. In nowadays, the corona issue also being cured by chemistry field. Chemistry is the important science involved in the transformations of matters too. Next example is salt. We used to have a salt in our daily life. Salt is nothing but it is a chemical compound. It is a mixture of NaCl and Cl. It is fascinating to know that salt, a compound, we eat every day. It is made up of two substances, sodium and chlorine, where sodium and chlorine also belongs to the elements of chemistry, which means that chemistry is present in everywhere in salt too. NaCl is said to be a table salt. Next, why meals are cooking faster in a pressure cooker? Anywhere we think that? No. A pressure cooker is a like a pot. Usually a pot is an open thing, but in a cooker it is filled with a lid. We used to put a whistle, everything that seals the pot completely, which with when you eat the mixture inside the pot, it boils and steams cannot escape, so that steams can't be will be evolved, so that the pressure stay inside that. So under the pressure, cooking temperature rises higher. The temperature normal condition also, it will be stay inside that cooker just because that is lid closed. So then the food is cooked much faster than anything. So in that cooker also, while waiting, while cooking also, chemistry is playing a major role in that the pressure is being evolved. It is a pictorial description of a cooker. We know that. Next, chemistry around the house. Sometimes is not. It's a major time. We used to have brushed our teeth. Brushed our teeth is a major thing. It's an important, essential work we do every day. Just a simple example is toothpaste. We used to have different types of toothpaste like Close-Up, Colgate, anything. Sometimes as a simple toothpaste also involves in a chemicals. Three chemicals has been involved. If not more, it's a mixture of fluoride, peroxide, baking soda, and its chemical reaction that keeps your teeth clean. From this course also, I got to know how to read the chemical composition. From that, it is not a simple toothpaste, it is not a single compound, it is mixture of compounds. In that also, chemistry is playing a major role. Next, this pictures will show that it is a scuba driving, which is a undersea driving. So gas is inside the scuba driving, so also a cylinders which is filled with the chemicals. Chemicals like oxygen, nitrogen, something. A diving cylinder, scuba tank, diving tank is a gas cylinder used to store the transport high pressure breathing gas as a component of scuba set. It provides us a scuba divers through the demand valve of diving regulator. It is a pictorial description of a scuba diving cylinders. The scuba diving tanks is also mixed with the nitrox, heliox and the hydrolux. Nitrox is a mixture of nitrogen, oxygen. It is also a chemicals. In heliox compound, oxygen and helium is also present. In hydrolux, it is also a mixture of oxygen, helium and nitrogen. It is also a chemical compound. In scuba diving, with the help of hydrolux, we can able to go a dive deep inside the 400 feet. Next, it is a trimix. Trimix is a mixture said to be a breathing gas. That is a major thing in chemistry we are using for scuba driving. Next, finally, we are living our life. Chemistry is every part and moment of our life. We must realize that the importance of chemistry in our daily life, from waking up morning to the time of sleeping. Chemistry moves with us like a shadow. It follows like shadow. Even while we sleep, chemistry is there with us. When we walk, we take fruit, we breathe, we bath, we drink, and we do any work every day. Everything is filled with chemistry. Chemistry is always with us. I learned from this course to many things such as body. We know that the elements and the compounds. Elements are the smallest substance and the components of the combination of elements. And a body is made up of millions of components. Every part of a body, tissues, veins, blood molecules are also the compounds is made up of chemistry. Finally, it is a chemistry. The word chemistry itself describes us. Chemistry is around everywhere. It is being in a health, environment, medicines, industries, science, teaching, research, and etc. So finally, I conclude that chemistry is the importance in our life. Thank you for listening. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon to everyone. My name is B. Kayalvili from second MSc Chemistry. I am going to present the topic about organic fertilizers and its importance for the society well-being.
Yes, continue please.
Good afternoon to everyone. Myself V. Kyle Willy from 2nd MSc Chemistry. I am going to the present topic about organic fertilizers and its importance for the society well-being. Next, organic farming principle. The organic principles of farming is health, ecology, fairness and care. Next, organic fertilizers. Organic fertilizers are comes from the plant or animal matters and contains carbon compounds. Examples, urea, sludge and animal tankage. Organic fertilizers are prepared from naturally and are made from the materials derived by living things. Advantages of organic fertilizers. Advantages of organic fertilizers is slow release of nutrients not easily reachable from the soil and add organic components to growing media. Inorganic fertilizers. Inorganic fertilizers comes from the chemical products. Chemical fertilizers are manufactured from synthetic material and chemical fertilizers are artificially prepared, very harmful for the health. Organic fertilizers versus chemical fertilizer. Organic fertilizers versus chemical fertilizers is quantity applied in organic is more than better. Organic quantity applied in the chemical is overdose can kill the plants. Expiration date for the organic is not possible. Expiration date from chemical is it will be possible. Soil structure for the organic is short and long term. Soil structure for the chemical is short term. Microorganisms for organic is millions. Microorganisms for chemical is there is none. Environmental for organic is easily biodegradable and environmental for chemical is pollutes the soil and water. Do not use chemical fertilizers because chemical fertilizers in effect kill the soil while organic fertilizers improve and maintain the soil. Our goal is healthy society, healthy people, healthy food and healthy soil. Bad effect for chemical fertilizer on human health is the toxic chemical found in fertilizers can be absorbed into the plant and enter into the food chain via vegetables and cereals. Although the biggest health risk is when the chemicals seep into the groundwater, which is then extracted from drinking water, creates many diseases and affect health and decreases the humanity. Our goal is healthy society and healthy people, healthy food and healthy soil. Organic farming, its reality is a purposeful approach to farming based on the regeneration and the promotion of life and health in the soil. Organic farming uses many traditional strategies such as crop rotation, green manuring, composting and fertilizing with organic wastes that serve as concern stones, fortresses for sustainable organic substance. Need feed for the soil, not for the plant. We offer premium quality organic fertilizers that improve the microbiological activity in the soil, creating the optimal conditions for growing big and healthy plant. Thank you.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. Myself Gayatri L from 2nd MSc Chemistry. My topic is carbon nanotubes. My topic is carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are the most successful material that are now attached a broad range of the scientists and the industry due to their physical and chemical property. In this post, we will take you through the structure synthesis and the most important application of carbon nanotubes in different field. Introduction. Carbon nanotubes, long thin cylinder of the carbon, were discovered in 1991 by Guillaume. Carbon nanotubes are of carbon, which are the member of the fluorine structural family, which also include the spherical. Large macromolecule, which has a unique for the size, shape, and rememberable physical property. The nature of the bonding of a nanotubes is described by the applied chemistry, specifically orbital hybridization. The chemical bonding of the nanotubes is composed of the sp2 bonds, similar to those of the graphite. This bonding structure, which is stronger than the sp3 bonds, bond found in the diamond, provide the molecule with their unique strength. Nanotubes naturally themselves into ropes, held together by the van der Waals force. Under the high pressure, nanotubes can together radiate some sp bonds, sp3 bonds, giving the possibility of the production strong ultimate length wire through high pressure nanotubes linking. History. The discovery that carbon could form stable or ordered structure other than graphite and the diamond stimulated researcher worldwide to search for the other new form of carbon. The search was given new impetus when it was shown in 1990 that carbon 60 be produced in a simple or evaporation apparatus available in all laboratories. It was using such a evaporation that the scientist Guillaume Leguizamo discovered in related carbon nanotubes in 1991. The tubes contain at last two layers, often many more, and the range in outer determined from about 3 nm to 3 nanometer. Nanotubes were observed in 1991 in the carbon stud of the graphite electrode during an discharge by using a current of the 100 ampere that was intended to the produce. However, the first production of the carbon nanotubes was made in 1992 by two researchers at the Fundamental Research Laboratory at FRAM. Thank you.
Good afternoon to one and all. Myself, E.D. Vasundhara. I am from first MSc Chemistry. My topic is about nuclear power plant or nuclear reactor. History of nuclear power plant. Electricity was generated for the first time ever by nuclear reactor on December 20, 1951 at the EBR-1 experimental station near Argo, Idaho in the United States. On June 27, 1954, the world's first nuclear power plant to generate electricity for the power grid started operation at Obnixik USSR, the world's first commercial scale power plant station, Cladder Hall in England, October 17, 1956. Nuclear fuel. Either enriched uranium or natural uranium is used as fuel. It is part of nuclear power plant where nuclear fission chain reaction is made to occur heat energy to liberate in the form of heat. Nuclear fission. When a neutron strike an atom of uranium, split into two lighter atoms and release heat simultaneously. Nuclear fission is an exothermic reaction which can emit tremendous amount of energy, about 200 mega electron volt. The diagram of nuclear fission. The diagram of nuclear reactor. Reactor definition. A nuclear reactor is an apparatus in which nuclear fission is produced in the form of self-controlled, self-sustained chain reaction. Compound of a nuclear reactor. Control rods. Boron and cadmium steel are used as the control rods to store observed neutrons and thereby control the rate of fission. Example, boron react with neutron, it will form lithium and helium. Steam generator. Steam generator or heat exchanger used to convert water into steam from heat producing in a nuclear reactor. So we can use either ordinary water or heavy water. Advantage and disadvantages of nuclear reactor. Advantage: high energy density, zero carbon emission, reliable and low cost energy. Disadvantage: water is radioactive and safe disposal is very difficult and expensive. Local thermal pollution from a water waste affects marine life. Applications of nuclear reactor. Nuclear energy can be used for industrial applications such as seawater desalination, hydrogen production, distinct heat or cooling, food treatment, space exploration, nuclear weapons, nuclear weapons. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. I am Priya from First Year of Chemistry. My topic is Indian medicinal plants. In that, I have chosen the plant. Rose its roots, root bark, and essential oil. Extract of root plant especially acts as an antidepressant, antibacterial, antifungal, antiseptic, anti-inflammatory, and for other purposes. Extract is taken from stem and bark or some parts of the plants. Rose oil contains some chemical compounds that will be usually used for our face mask. We will be using this rose oil. Some parts of the chemical compound are citrullinol, geraniol, neroli, linolol, phenylethyl alcohol. uses of rose oil is it will reduce our stresses, depression, pain, and increase mood. The next plant is tulsi. Tulsi will give a good smell and it will be growing in a small patch of the area. It is taken from family of Lanaceae. It is mainly cultivated for religious and medicinal purposes. It is used as a herbal tea in Ayurveda side and it will be used as a drugs. Curry leaves was originally grown in India for its aromatic leaves. It will also give good smell. It is added to numerous dishes. It will reduce our weights and it has vitamin A, B, C and B12. It will give iron and calcium content for our body. It is against the antioxidant. It will short our memory power. Good afternoon everyone, I am Amelika from the Department of Holistic Chemistry. Today my topic is about non-volatile anesthetics. Anesthetics, the term anesthesia means loss of sensation. It is derived Greek words anesthesia, which means insensibility. Anesthesia produces insensibility to the vital function of all types of cells, especially those of nervous system. May be divided into two types, general anesthetics, local anesthetics. General anesthetics, the anesthetics belonging to this produce unconsciousness all over the body by depressing central nervous system to such that the sensitivity, pain or feeling is lost. Local anesthetics, these agents abolish the sensation, pain in localized area. They do not affect whole body, but a part of body become insensitive to any pain or feeling. These drugs affect the peripheral nervous tissue and blood nerve conduction and those abolish all sensation in the part supplied by the nerve. Intravenous or non-volatile anesthetic, this anesthetic produces unconsciousness when they are administered parently or intravenously. They induct anesthesia rapidly. There are some ultra-short-acting barbiturates like thiopental sodium and non-barbiturates such as eugenol derivative, propine diol, fenciclidine derivative, example ketamine, steroid, example alprazine, etomidate. They are some of the important drugs which are used non-volatile general anesthetics. Thiopental sodium, chemically it is named as 5-ethyl-5-1-methyl-2-thiobarbiturates. When administered intravenously, it produces complete anesthesia, short duration. The patient passes through the stage of hypnosis, deep sleep to anesthesia. First, the consciousness is lost and the reflex activity is lost. And lastly, the medullary center are lost. It is used as anesthetic agent for operation of short duration fracture dental surgery. Advantage, it is non-explosive and is easily to administer. Induction is rapidly and without unpleasant feeling or irritation. The tendency of nausea, vomiting and excitement is much less. It does not affect respiratory and recovery is fast. Generally, there are no post-anesthetic complications. Disadvantage, it need constant supervision to avoid overdosage. It depresses vasomotor and myocardium. It is poor analgesic. It does not produce adequate muscular relaxation. It has disadvantage like a falling blood pressure respirator and may produce involuntary movements such as tremors. It also produces nausea, vomiting, headache, excessive salivation. Thank you.
Good afternoon, one and all present here. I am Gabe Nolni from First MSc Chemistry. Today my topic is food chemistry. Introduction: Food chemistry. Food chemistry is nothing but the study of producing, processing, preparing, evaluating, and using foods. The study of how your body uses the food you eat is nutrition. Substances that are found in food are needed by the body to function, grow, repair itself, and produce energy are called nutrition. Your body needs over 50 different nutrition, which can be divided into 6 classes: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and water. Major biomolecules. First, carbohydrates, fats, proteins. For example, carbohydrates, complex carbohydrates provides vitamins, minerals, and fibers. First, carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen in a ratio of 1:2:1 ratio. Functions of carbohydrates: provides body pain, source of energy, provide bulk, helps the body digest fast. Sources of carbohydrates: sugars, honey, jam. Fiber sources: fruits, vegetables, whole grains. Starch sources: breads, cereals, pasta. Types: simple sugars, complex sugars. First, unsaturated fats from when each carbon atom in the fatty acid chain is joined to another carbon atom, a single covalent bond. Solid at room temperature, example butter. Macro minerals, nutrition function sources. Calcium functions, builds bones and teeth, helps muscles and nerves work. Sources: dairy products, leaf, green vegetables. Magnesium, its function, helps cells use energy, nutrition, regulates body temperature. Sources: beans, dark green leafy vegetables, whole grains. Phosphorus, its function, builds bones and teeth, regulates bodily activities. Sources: protein and calcium from food sources. Sodium, chlorine, and potassium, its functions, control homeostasis, maintain acid-base balance in the body. Sources: sodium and chlorine salt table, potassium bananas. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all present here. Myself, G. Satya from First MSc Chemistry. Today is my topic is History of Organic Chemistry. Outline: History of Organic Chemistry, Atomic Theory, Electrochemical Theory, Preparation of Artificial Urea, Radical Theory, Conclusions. History of Organic Chemistry, the Blogiston Theory. It explained George Ernest Dalby, the year of 1662-1734. It explained the Blogiston Theory was prevalent in the 18th. When metal were heated in air, wax was formed, and phlogiston was lost. Since the wax was always heavier than the metal, phlogiston must have a negative mass. Which is a mass of the vessel did not change. He also noted that dephlogisticated air was essential for breathing. In spite of this observation, he is nonetheless remainder of supporter of the phlogiston theory. Berlioz, John Probus Berlioz, in the year of 1779-1848, they explained the theory of electrochemical theory. Berlioz provided the modern symbols of the elements and defined isomerism. Isomerism defined as the equal part. Isomerism have the same composition but not the same physical properties. Berlioz held that organic compounds that like or inorganic ones had electropositive and electronegative compounds. One of the preparation of artificial urea. I can't, so to say, help my chemical water, and I must tell you that I can make urea without needing to have a kind or anyhow an animal, be it human or dogs. It explains the 18th Kohler to Berzelius, the year of 1828. Linus Pauling, in the year of 1901 to 1994, they explained the quantum mechanism as to resonance hybridization, molecular orbital theory, the nature of chemical bond. Thank you.
Good afternoon to everyone. My topic is chemistry of the taste and aroma in coffee. Myself, Rajalakshmi from MSc Chemistry. History of coffee. Coffee plant organized in Africa and Madagascar. Coffee is being universal. It is very kind of real level. Various activities you perform during the day. Introduction to coffee is enjoyed by millions of people around the world. The sincere experience when the consumption of cup of coffee is one of the key aspects of the drink. The factor composition of coffee. Coffee contains about 1,500 chemicals. The different groups of chemicals present in coffee are aliphatic compounds, carbonate compounds, ketones, aromatic benzoyl compounds, etc. Taste components of coffee is coffee's taste is received mostly on the tongue by the taste buds, sweet, sour, salty, bitter, savory in the early 1500s. How coffee keeps us awake? It's normal practice to drink coffee to stay awake. Here is how it works. Vessels to dilate. To let more oxygen, natural brain chemicals, adenones that is associated with sleep. Coffee benefits and properties are main applications containing fat relieving headaches and emergence. Supporting compounds and the medicinal actions is the coffee. Liquid extract concentrated from made from raw coffee beans. Tablets in this supplement from is also made of green beans and it does not provide the same antioxidants or of roasted coffee. The conclusion of coffee is evolve with the consistency of each pairwise project with pairwise alignment. Alternative pairwise alignments could not be added to the library to include more information between segments. Thank you for me giving this opportunity. Thank you. Good afternoon to all. Myself is Mohan Mageshwari from First MSc Chemistry. My topic is chemistry of ink, dyes and pigment. Introduction. Color provides a significant difference to our world. Everyday materials we tend to use different types of materials like textiles, paints, plastic, paper and foodstuffs. Colors bring off most appearing. In summer there is a wild burst of colorful flowers and new use of various shades. Dye is nothing but a colored substance that has a substrate to which it is being applied. The dye is applied in an aqueous solution and needs a moderate to the process of dye on the textile paper.
Lambda is a color substrate that has an affinity to the substrate to which it is said to be applied. It is an ionizing and aromatic compound with the chromophore of the same material component. The structure have arranged rings that they have pigments. Pigments obey the colors they are all best. They selectively reflect and absorb certain wavelength of visible light. The appearance of pigment is intimate, connected to the color of the source light. Classification of pigments, that is biological pigments, organic pigments, inorganic pigments. Conclusion, natural dyes generally supposed to be cheap, non-toxic, worthwhile, sustainable resource with minimal environmental impact. Have the attention of a scientific community to use them by traditional and newly discovered application recipes. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Ashani from MSc Chemistry. My topic is Chemistry in Human Body. Elements that make up the human body. The body is of all intents and purpose of extraordinary complex machine. This requires a multitude of parts or working together and uncompleted relationships from the micro and macro levels. The structure of the building blocks are made up of some responses such as proteins, nucleic acids, determined by the proportion and the intention of chemicals. Carbon. Carbon is the most common element in the human body, making up of 18% of the body mass. It is the role mostly structural, forming the backbone. Calcium. Calcium is the most abundant metal in the human body, around 1.4% of body mass. It is almost well-known function of bones, teeth, and lack of calcium is diet can lead to a variety of degenerative conditions. Our body is made up of chemical particles, 60% of oxygen, 8.5% of carbon, 9.5% of hydrogen, 3.5% of nitrogen, and other elements for 3.5%. Chlorine plays an essential role in maintaining the acid-base balance of blood along with the formation of a dental steam membranes. It commonly found in the salts and combination of potassium, sodium in the body. It also contributes liver function and helps to eliminate magnesium. Magnesium is the least common of essential elements in the body. Some 300 to or some enzymes require magnesium ions. To function properly, magnesium ions interact with the compounds such as DNA, RNA, and ATP. The main source of all these elements is diet. Some of the elements are mostly essential than others. Some can even cause active harm to the body. The level of at which we are present in the body can determine just how harmful the effects are.
Everyone present here. My name is Najiha Suman from first MSc Chemistry. The topic of my presentation is dye chemistry. Before going to the topic, let us discuss few things about dyes. Human is always fascinated by colors. Because we are living in a colorful world, we would see colors in plants and animals. We eat colored foodstuffs and we would see numerous colored materials. Where do they get from? Because of some chemicals present in it. Using of colorant by the mankind for painting and dyes dates back to the dawn of civilization. At the middle of 19th century, the human being only used the colorant obtained from natural things. For example, if we take inorganic colorants like manganese oxide, hematite and soot, it is the made up of iron. It is used for colorants. Organic compound is also used as colorants. Dyes. What are dyes? Dyes is a natural or synthetic substance used to color or to change the color of something. Let's move on to the next topic. Dye chemistry. Dye chemistry is the study of synthetic dyes. Dyes contain chromophore and oxochrome group. Dyes impart the color of dye. Important chromophores are NO2, NO, N double bond N, C double bond O, C double bond S. Structure of dye is a group of chromophore and oxochrome. Classification of dyes. Dyes are classified based on chromophore present in the molecule, such as nitro dyes, nitroxo dyes, azo dyes, and quinone dyes. Classification of dyes is a method of application of dyes to fibers, such as acidic dyes, basic dyes, direct dyes, modern dyes, and bad dyes. Uses of dyes. This coloring substance are used in different types of industries like textiles, paper, leather wood, food and food industries. Example, soluble dyes and modern dyes added to soap fiber to form insoluble dye coating on the fiber. Variety of petroleum based items such as lubricating oils, waxes, gasolines and polishers use this coloring substance. Application of dyes are widely used by industries for inks and printing. Dyes are used by textile industries for cloth coloring. They are resistant to ultraviolet light. They conduct electricity. They are free of heavy metals, so they are also used in cosmetic stuff. Thank you.
I am Surathul Chabak from the Department of Biochemistry. Today, my topic is all about DNA, genetics, and the facts about the DNA. Let me start by saying DNA is a deoxyribonucleic acid. It is a complex molecule that contains all the information necessary to build and maintain an organism. Every cell has a DNA. DNA is a group of molecules that is responsible for carrying and transmitting heredity material to the offspring. DNA is found in all prokaryotic and eukaryotic organisms. DNA consists of three types. They are ADNA, dDNA, and zDNA. Let me say few things about a DNA. That is the facts about DNA. Our DNA consists of 5 to 8% of viral DNA. Our ancestors' DNA is passed on to us even. Genes involved in the sperms and are the most rapidly evolving genes in an animal kingdom. A zombie gene in elephants might help protect them from cancer. Octopus can edit their own DNA gene. The idea that a single gene determines whether you have attached or unattached earlobe is a myth. There isn't a wanderlust gene or a music gene. DNA testing kit can't tell something about how smart you are. The word DNA was coined until the 20th century. On a genetic level, all human beings have a DNA. Thank you. I thank the management for providing me this opportunity.
I would like to welcome Ms. T. Gayatri Devi from the Department of Chemistry to deliver the welcome vote of thanks.
Good evening to Vanadar. Vote of thanks. No duty is more urgent than giving a thanks. I would maintain that thanks are the highest form of the thought and that the gratitude is happiness doubled by wonder. Appreciation is a wonderful thing. It makes what is excellent in others belongs to us as well. First, I would like to thank our Almighty God for successful completion of 2 days spiritual conference on future materials and its applications. Next, my immense pleasure to thank our secretary sir and trustees who is absent here for giving us an approval to conduct this conference. Thank you, sir. In addition, my gratitude is with our honorable principal ma'am, Dr. M. Indoli ma'am, and our beloved PRO, Ms. B. Shaktimala ma'am, for our constant support and encouragement. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to thank our chief guest, Dr. W. Madhuri ma'am, Associate Professor, Center for Functional Materials, Vellore Institute of Technology, Vellore. Ma'am, you gave a clear knowledge about hybrid microwave sintering of ceramics for electrical applications. Thank you, ma'am, for your excellent explanations with your interesting skills. Next, I would like to thank Dr. Akila Sivaramakrishnan, sir, Professor, Department of Chemistry, School of Advanced Science, Vellore Institute of Technology, Vellore. Sir, you gave us a clear idea about the metal complexes beyond your expectation, motivating us and creating interest in organometallic studies. Thank you, sir. Next, I would like to thank Dr. D. Zarina, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Jawaharlal Nehru Technology University, Anantapur, Andhra Pradesh. Ma'am, you have explained about the structural studies of peptides. Now we got a clear idea and the interesting to do the project on it. Thank you so much, ma'am. And our special gratitude to our department HODs, HOD ma'am, Dr. M. Charumati ma'am, Head Department of Chemistry, and Dr. C. Pavitra ma'am and Dr. B. Sabari ma'am, Head Department of Physics. Thank you, ma'am, for all your efforts and encouragements. And my sincere thanks to our session chair for presentation, Dr. P. K. Mohammed Imran, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Islamia College, Autonomous, Vanyambadi. Thank you so much, sir. My next gratitude to all the aides and faculty members and participants for various sectors. I render my hearty gratitude to our technical team members for the timely arrangements. Thank you all. Last but not least, I thank you, my friends, for your cooperation in making this function a resounding success. Thank you, friends. Finally, I leave you with an inspiring quote. Keep your face to the sunshine. And you can't see a shadow. Once you replace negative thoughts with positive ones, you will start having a positive results. Positive thinking will let you do everything better than negative thinking will. Once again, thank you all.
Thank you, Gayatri. Let's end the session with validatory video. Thanks to everyone present here. Thank you.